This is a presentation of the paper, The Topology of Local Computing in Networks. My name is Pierre Fregnaud, I am from CNRS and Université de Paris, and this is a joint work with Ami Paz from Universitat Vienne. The paper is about distributed computing. So in distributed computing, we have a set of autonomous processes, P1 to PN, and these processes are exchanging information via some communication medium. They are aiming at solving tasks. So what is a task? In a task, every process PI starts with some input value XI, and it must eventually output some value YI. And there are, of course, some input-output relations specifying the task. So an output y, I mean a vector of output y is correct with respect to some input vector x, if and only if the vector y satisfies the specification of the task with respect to the input vector x. In fact, instead of talking about vectors, it is much more convenient to talk about simplices and complexes. And in fact, in this paper, we will use the framework introduced by Early and Chabit and Zaks and Zaraoglu at the turn of the century, which is viewing distributed computing through the lens of algebraic topology. The result by these authors enabled them to receive the Gödel Prize in 2004. So just let me remind you that a simplicial complex, K, is simply a collection of non-empty subsets of a finite set V. And the main property is that these subsets must be downward closed under inclusion. So V is denoting the set of vertices, and every subset of K is called a simplex. So in this figure, for instance, you can see the vertices as black dots, edges, and you can see also full triangle and even tetrahedron. So now tasks can be formalized in this context as follows. So we can define an input complex, which is formed of the following vertices. Each vertex is a pair, I, XI, where I is the index of the process, PI, and XI is the input of this process. And simplices are just sets of legal input configurations. So for instance, on the figure on the right, you can see an input complex in which there are three processes, the white one, the gray one, and the black one. And the processes can receive input 0 or 1, and there are no constraints on the collection of inputs, so you can have all possible combinations of zeros and 1. And so the input complex in this case is homomorph to the sphere, the two-dimensional sphere. Now, the output complex, again, it's the vertex set is formed of pairs I, YI, where I is the index of the process, and YI is some output value. And the simplices are the set of legal output configuration. Again, on the figure on the right, you can see at the bottom an output complex in which there are only two legal output configurations, the set of all ones and the set of all zeros. This is, for instance, the case in consensus. And the specification of the task is done using a carrier map that specifies for each input simplex the collection of output complex that are legal with respect to this input. So, for instance, in the case of consensus, if the system starts with all processes with input 1, they are bounded to all output 1. But if the system starts with some processes input 1 and some other processes input 0, then they can output either all 1s or all 0s as long as they agree. So computation can also be modeled in the framework of topology by defining protocol complex. So protocol complex, they are indexed by the time t, where the notion of time may depend on the model. So at time 0, the protocol complex is simply the input complex. And at time t, a vertex of the protocol complex pt is a pair isi, where I is the index of the process, and si is the state of the process pi at time t. So a simplex of the protocol complex pt is just a set of legal global states. So it's the collection of mutually compatible pairs I, Si. Finally, algorithms can also be modeled as in the framework of topology by noticing that an algorithm that outputs some value at time t induces a mapping from the protocol complex to the output complex. So specifically, if pi in state si at time t outputs some value yi, then we can define a mapping delta where the image of delta of I si is the pair I yi, which is a vertex in the output complex. Note that this mapping is name preserving in the sense that, of course, a process doesn't change name when it outputs a value. This figure represents all the aspects of distributed computing in a single diagram. So on the left, top left, we have the input complex. On the bottom right, we have the output complex. We have the specification of the task delta. Now, on the top right, we have the protocol complex. And so, in fact, this protocol complex can be viewed as a topological transformation of the input complex, whose nature depends on the computational model at hand. And finally, we have the algorithm, which maps vertices from the protocol complex to vertices of the output complex. And now, one of the main results of Early and Chavit is to characterize what does it mean to solve a task. So a task IO delta is solvable in time t if and only if there exists a name-preserving simplicial map delta. So the map delta, which goes from pt to o, must be simplicial, must preserve the simplices of the protocol complex. Every simplex of the protocol complex must be mapped to a simplex of the output complex. And of course, the mapping should agree with delta. Here I am avoiding some technical details. So now we have a global figure, a global picture of distributed computing through the lens of algebraic topology. What is the outcome of this formalism? Well, it's huge. Actually, a plethora of positive and negative results were obtained during the last two decades using this framework. And I am referring here to the book of Early, Koslov and Rajbom, which presents a survey of all kind of large, of very many results that can be obtained using topology in various frameworks. Now, all these results, they apply to all-to-all communication media only. So to share memory or to message passing. And one question that was addressed very recently is, what about network computing? Can we apply topology also to network computing? So for instance, let us consider one of the main models of network computing, which is a so-called local model. So now it's not an all-to-all communication. The communication occurs only along the edges of the graph. So we have a network which is modeled as an n-node graph, G. And every node pi is given some ID, which is usually in a polynomial range between 1 and n to the c for some constant c greater than 1. And it's a failure-free model. So no crashes, no failures. And it's a synchronous model. So the computation performed in log steps. So there is a notion of round, and all the processes start at the same time, and at every round, every node sends a message to each of its neighbors, receives the messages that were sent by its neighbors, and performs some individual computation. And here it's important to notice that the message are unbounded. So actually, it's a full information protocol which enables the framework of Early and Chavit to apply. Last year, Armando Castaneda, myself, Ami Paz, Sergio Rajbom, Mathieu Roy, and Corentin Travers, we studied the topological approach for the local model. So we consider the same framework as Early and Chavit. And we consider complexes where the vertices are of the form I, ID, I, VI. Now it's a triplet. So I, again, is the index or name of a process. So it's between 1 and n. ID, I is the ID which is given to this process. So it's, again, in a polynomial range. And VI, it depends on the context, can be the, an input value or an output value, or simply the view of a, of a process in the protocol complex. So what is the view? It's just a ball of reduced T in the network. Now, it's important to note that the protocol complex depends on the structure of the network, because, of course, the balls depends, the structure of the balls depends on the structure of the graph. And therefore, what the information that can be acquired by a process in T-round depends a lot on the structure of the network G. And one of the main contributions of Castaneda et al. Was to identify a new form of topological deformation that they call scissor cuts. So for instance, on this figure, I just represent the case of consensus. We have the input complex, the output complex, and you see in the middle two types of scissor cuts that are depending on the structure of the network. And one of the main contributions of their paper is to establish a correspondence between the structure of the network G and the homology of the protocol complex PT. And this result enabled Castaneda et al. To, using this global approach, to derive a certain number of results, essentially lower bound, for various problems and typically agreement problems. So these problems are like consensus, so everybody must agree on the same value, K-set agreement, in which the processes must agree in at most in a set of at most K values, approximate consensus, etc. Now, the crucial point here is that all these tasks, the specification of these tasks, are actually independent of the network structure. So a natural question, and that was the motivation of this for this paper now, is what about tasks that depend on the network structure? Most of the tasks that actually are to be solved in the context of network computing refer to the network structure. So they can be coloring, maximal independent set, maximal matching, minimum weight spanning tree, etc. All these tasks are specified and the output depend on the structure of the network. So what is the difference between our approach and the approach of Castaneda et al.? Well, our approach is entirely local. So let's consider, for instance, the class GD of the regular graph with degree D. So in our approach, which is local, the simplices are not composed of n vertices. I mean, the facets are not composed of n vertices, but on simply d plus 1 vertices. A node P0 and its neighbors P1, PD. So the vertices of the complexes that we are considering are of the form triplets, I, ID, IVI, but the index I is not in 1n, but simply in 0d. Also, the IDs, as we will see, the IDs are not in a polynomial range which depend on the number of processes, but they are in a finite set of processes whose range depends only on the degree and not on the number of nodes. And again, VI is of course some input output value or views depending whether we consider the input complex, the output complex, or the protocol complex. For instance, let us consider the maximal independent set problem in the ring. So let's assume here we have a ring, and let's assume that the nodes have a consistent notion of left and right. And instead of using P0, P1, P2, I will instead use P0 for the center node, P-1 for its left neighbors, and P1 for its right neighbors. So the left neighbors will be black, the center node will be white, and the right neighbor will be blue. So, for instance, in MIS, here is the formulation of MIS in this context. So, if the center node is in the MIS, its label is 1, then none of its neighbors must be in the MIS. Both of them should be 0. Instead, if the center node, the white node, is 0, is not in the MIS, then its neighbors may or may not be in the MIS as long as at least one of its neighbors is in the MIS. So this is the resulting local complex corresponding to MIS. Note that the triangle 0, 0, 0, for instance, is not a facet, as well as a facet in which one The white node is one, and the sum of the neighbor blue or black is one, is also not a facet of the local complex of MIS. We can play the same thing for tricoloring the ring. So again, we assume that we have the ring with a consistent notion of left and right, and tricoloring, we want to proper color the nodes with colors in 1, 2, or 3. So this figure displays the local complex of tricoloring. Again, we have, let's say, for instance, on the left square, we have the center node, which is colored 1. So all its neighbors may have colors 2 or 3, as long as they have no color 1 in it. Same thing for the center square, the center node is colored 3, so its neighbors can be colored either 1 or 2, but definitely not 3. And now we can ask, is there a way to do some reduction from tricoloring to MIS in the ring? Let's say, for instance, is there a zero-round algorithm? The processes start with a tricoloring, and can they, without communication, output some value MIS 0 or 1, representing 0 if they are not in the MIS, 1 they are in the MIS. So this corresponds to the question, or is there a mapping from the input complex, which is the complex of coloring, of tricoloring, to the output complex, which is the complex of MIS. And this mapping must not only be name-preserving, as before, but it must be name-independent, in the sense that P0, P1, P-1, there are notions that are not available to the processes themselves, they are just in the model. So it should be a mapping which is name-independent and name-preserving. We can ask the same question about the existence of a one-round algorithm. So this is the protocol complex after one round. So actually it's composed of three disconnected components. So representing the views of the compatible views of the nodes after one round. And again, we can show, it's not as easy to show as before, that there is no simplicial name-independent, name-preserving mapping from this protocol complex P1 to the output complex of MIS. After two rounds, can we do? Aha! It happens that after two rounds, the protocol complex consists of 12 disconnected components, and there is indeed a mapping from this protocol complex to the output complex of MIS. It's a little bit bizarre because each component looks the same as they look in the protocol complex after one round, but remember that the mapping should be name independent and name preserving. And after two rounds, we have more flexibility for the mapping, and actually we can show that this mapping exists. And there is in fact indeed a trivial algorithm to do reduction from tricoloring to MIS in the ring in two rounds. So what is our general framework? We are not working, of course, only on coloring and MIS. We are working on so-called locally checkable labeling. So what is a locally checkable labeling? So in this labeling, every node is given a label taken from a finite set L. And there is a local specification S for a labeling to be correct or to be legal or not. So for instance, for coloring, if you take K coloring, the labels are values 1, 2, up to K, and a labeling is correct if and only if for every two adjacent nodes, they have two different labels. Same thing for MIS, the labels are 0 or 1. If you are labeled 1, all of your neighbors must be labeled 0, because it's an independent set, and if a node is labeled 0, then at least one of its neighbors should be labeled 1, because we want maximal independent set. And what is an LCL task? The input is specified by some LCL, L in, S in, and the output is specified also by some LCL, L out, S out, and there are also some potential input-output relation, like in list coloring. And the objective is starting from some input labeling from the LCL L in S in, is to compute some output labeling corresponding to a legal labeling corresponding to L out S out. So that's the general framework. At this point, I just mentioned discussion without IDs. How do we deal with IDs? Well, we are essentially using the same technique as Nauer and Stockmeyer's, and the main ingredient is Ramsey theorem. And in Ramsey theorem, I just want here to point out that, of course, there is a Ramsey value, which depends on various parameters that I will not discuss. And this R will appear in the name in the next slide. This Ramsey value is what enable us to discuss about constant number of IDs instead of discussing about the number of IDs that depends on the number of processes. So what is our main result? It's a constant reformulation of theorem à la Early and Chavit. So on the left-hand side of this slide, you have the diagram corresponding to the global approach that was used by Castaneda et al. Last year. So we have some input complex whose size depends on the number of processes, little n, and also on the number of IDs, capital N, where capital N is typically polynomial in the size of the network. Same thing for the output complex, which depends on the number of nodes and the number of IDs, and of the protocol complex. And we have this typical triangle, which is the Early and Chavit diagram. In this paper, in our local approach, the tasks are defined independently of the IDs. They are defined only as input complex, which depends only on D, that's the bottom horizontal line of the right diagram. So we have just a mapping, a carrier map from the input complex to the output complex, that whose size depends only on the degree of the network. Then, when we perform computation with IDs, so that's the right line of the diagram. But the input complex and the protocol complex depends on the IDs, but the number of IDs is bounded, is finite, from 1 to R, where R does not depend on the size of the network, but depends only on the number of rounds of the computation and on of the degree of the network. And now we have again a commutative diagram that we can resume in the following theorem, which says that for every LCL task on graph of maximum degree D, and for every T, there exists some R such that the task T is solvable in T round in the local model, if and only if there is a simplicial map from the protocol complex whose size depends only on the time T, the degree D, and the constant R, to the output complex that, of course, agree with the specification of the task. But what is crucial here is that all the complexes are of constant size, as opposed to what, if we follow directly blindly the early Chavit approach, in which case the size of the complexes depends on the size of the nodes. As an application of our main theorem, we reprove the famous result by Lignal, stated that essentially tricoloring the n-node ring requires log star n rounds. What we showed is that reduction from c-coloring to tricoloring cn requires omega of log star c rounds. And the proof goes as follows. So let's assume that we have a t-round algorithm for k-coloring. So this algorithm induced a simplicial map delta from PTR to OK. Now let's we can construct a functor that has the following properties. So the protocol complex is mapped to some other complex phi of PTR. The output complex for K coloring is mapped to some complex phi of OK. Since it's a functor phi, the mapping delta, the simplicial map delta, is mapped to a simplicial map phi of delta. And this functor phi has a crucial property, two actually crucial properties. First, the image of the output complex for k-coloring is actually included in the output complex for 2 to the 2 to the k-coloring. And also, we can show that there exists a simplicial map f from the protocol complex after t minus 1 round to the image of the protocol complex after t rounds by phi. Therefore, by combining f and phi of delta, we obtain a simplicial map delta prime from the protocol complex after t minus one round to the protocol complex O of 2 to the 2 to the k. Which means that if there exists a t-round algorithm for k coloring, then there exists a t minus one algorithm for 2 to the 2 to the 2. 2 to the 2 to the k coloring. If we iterate these things, we obtain the corollary. So the conclusion, there are two complementary approaches of distributed network computing through the lens of algebraic topology. One is a global approach that was introduced last year by Castaneda et al., and which is well suited to study tasks whose specifications are global, like consensus, k-set agreement, etc., and one local, which is done in this paper, which seems to be very well suited to study tasks whose specifications are purely local, like coloring MIS and LCL tasks in general.